वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अग्निहोत्र और संस्कारस वर्सेस अग्निहोत्र संस्कारस एंड शांति कर्मस एंड संध्यावदनम. आई थिंक पीपल आर लाइक आई सॉ दैट इन द ग्रुप पीपल आर लाइक कन्फ्यूज्ड. दे आर ट्राइंग टू कोरिलेट ईच एंड एवरीथिंग विद दैट एंड दे थिंक दिस इज द सेम थिंग और दे आर नॉट हैविंग अ क्लैरिटी. सो आई थॉट आई विल पुट दिस वीडियो एंड यू माइट इट माइट हेल्प यू टू हैव सम क्लैरिफिकेशन. First part is Sandhyavandanam is done by a set of people, that is to invoke the divinity inside them when they are taken certain initiatives to say certain mantras and balance the elements inside their five elements of the nature inside them. So that is a process they do it daily. There is not just in the morning, there is a certain practice and certain ways they learn it from their gurus and they follow it. The second part is Agnihotra is something anybody can do it. Again, there are multiple methods here. There is a Vedic method here and there is another Siddha method here. Okay, so you can learn it from any of those things and you can practice it by yourself. That is to purify the environment around and the purifying inner self. Basically, it purifies your aura, your energy levels around, and it influences the people around. Okay, so that is what Agnihotra is all about. Samskaras is something as a parent you have to do certain set of duties to help them release from their bad karma or release them from the bond between you and the child, because else the loop will keep on continuing. So for that, when you do certain samskaras, some of the threads get disconnected and they can evolve as an individual soul in their life. This is the parents who do it for the children. The last one is the Shanti Karma. Shanti Karma is the area where you do it on yourself. It is not you are doing it for the children. As a soul, you accumulate certain things in your life. Okay, so when you are practicing certain spiritual practice in your life, rituals or any other things, when you do it on a daily basis, these are nothing but offloading your karma, slowly vaporizing it and avoiding adding new one in the life. Okay, but there is also a hacking method. Like even if you miss all those things, for example, many people when I took samskaras, they all were telling, oh my god, my child is almost 15 now, I missed all those things, what can I do? You can't go and unchain certain things in the back. There are some areas you can do it, but most of the time what is done in the past, nobody has control over it. So but for the Shanti Karma, the beauty here is, even if you miss many of these shantis, the soul needs certain kind set of shantis here. Okay, it's not just, many people confuse that with Shashashta Purti and think that 60th wedding anniversary is the Shanti Karma. No, it is there till 120 years. Right from the 9 and a half till 120 years, there are some what you call lunar nodes where certain time there is a small gap in your in your constellation around the, as planets are revolving. There are certain gaps. Even if you miss this all these years, when you perform certain rituals or when you perform certain meditation, it's not about just ritual. Okay, if you can do those things, you can actually help, it will help you to cover it up or help you cleanse those part. So some people do it through form of rituals, some people can do inner self, they can do certain kind of mental exercise that will help them cleanse it, but doing at that particular time only these things work. So that is what the Shanti Karma is all about. So we'll be covering from 8 and a half, then there is another one at 18, another one is at 35 or 39, then another one is 55, 54, 60, 70, like that we keep on going. So there is multiple time you get certain gap in your in the nature where you have time to compensate it. If you miss 60 years or maybe at that particular time when you do this ritual, that kind of shanti your soul will immediately, the soul needs those kinds of peace. So you can recreate it using rituals or you can do it through meditation. That is what we are going to do about Shanti Karma in the upcoming webinar. That's what we are going to cover on it. So I hope this clarifies. So don't confuse if all these things are same. These are very, very different, and there are multiple school of thoughts here. So what I have learned from my guru is what I'm going to share it and what I practice. But there are a lot of things available. So wherever you find it more useful and wherever you want to do it, but definitely learn it and put it into your day-to-day life. It will definitely help you to elevate your soul and it will reduce certain lifetime in your next couple of rebirth that you might have to take it. It will reduce and most probably it might even take you to an enlightened state. So I hope this clarifies and I'll meet you in another interesting video. Bye.